So as you can see, we're going to say it looks like long radio waves, they have the highest wavelength, because they're above 10 to the 8 meters. But as a result, their frequency is very low. Say they would have the lowest frequency. And on the other side, it looks like gamma rays is 10 to the 24 for frequency. So this would have, these guys would have the highest frequency. And on the bottom, therefore, it would have the lowest wavelength. So looking at what happens to our frequency when our wavelength is affected, remember we've talked about this before. We would say that the relationship between frequency and wavelength is that they are inversely proportional, which means they're opposites of one another. And the way you should understand it visually is like this. So we have light travel sometimes as waves, according to some theorists. So here are some waves. These represent a bunch of light particles together. Now, what we're going to say here is that frequency is how many waves do you get per second? And then here we're going to say that wavelength is the distance from one top of the wave to the other. So in this image here, we'd say that the distance is pretty big. So we'd say that the wavelength is high. But we only get three waves in a second. That's not that many. So we'd say that our frequency is low. Now, if we drew a different picture, okay, this is roughly the same distance as the first set of waves that I showed you. But here now you would say that the distance from one top of the wave to the other, the crest, the wavelength looks like it's very small. So the wavelength would be low. And you would also say that we get a lot more waves per second, per that period of time. So you'd say that frequency here is high. So visually, this is how you would show that frequency and wavelength are inversely proportional, meaning that they're opposites of one another. We talked about this when we talked about the relationship between certain factors such as pressure and volume. They're inversely proportional to each other. Okay, same way, wavelength and frequency are inversely proportional. Now, what does this have to do with our electromagnetic spectrum? Well, our electromagnetic spectrum is a way of associating light with energy. We're going to say here, highest frequency, frequency has a direct relationship to energy. So we'd say that gamma rays, according to this spectrum, have the highest frequency, and therefore they have the highest energy. So they're both directly related to each other. And remember, wavelength and frequency are opposites of one another. So if my energy is high, therefore my wavelength would be low. And on this other side, because my frequency is low, that means my energy is low. It's going to become important that you guys remember the order of these different types of light sources, because your professor will easily ask one of them on the exam, rank these in terms of increasing energy, rank these in terms of increasing frequency. So it becomes important to remember the order.